welcome back to my channel SimSprint. So today we are diving into an awesome Excel function that's perfect for anyone interested in stocks or want to investing or just want to analyze market trends. It's called the stochastic function and it's let us pull historical data directly into Excel. We don't need any manual downloads or copying data from websites. So let's get it started and then see how it works. But before jumping on that, if you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe SimSprint. I will be very thankful for that. So we need to know what his stock history function do, right? So the stock history function, it is a built-in Excel feature that allows us to retrieve historical stock prices, volumes and the other market data for any publicly traded company. So it can be used to analyze trends, compare stocks, or even build your own financial models. So the best part, you know what? It's super easy to use. Yes, it's very super easy to use. You can see on the screen the syntax for the stock history is stock history and then the stock, and then the start date, end date, interval, header and properties. The stock, it is a ticker symbol of the company, like I have taken the example of Apple. So or either we can use the reference cell that containing tickers, and then the start date, end date, use this format, year, month and date, or either the reference cells can be used. Intervals, it's daily, weekly or monthly data, it's optional. So daily, either we can use 0, it means daily, 1 is weekly, 2 means monthly, or either we can write it down as a daily, weekly or monthly, right? And then the headers, if you want to, it's also an optional. So if we want to add headers, 0 means no headers, 1 means include headers, right? And then the properties, it's a specific data points like price, volumes, it's also optional, right? So for example, like we want to get the closing price, so we will use close, or either it can be used 1. High daily, like the high price of the daily high price of the whatever the company we used, and then the volume, trading volume, and then we can say the lower price, and then the the combined properties also can be used, like close, high and volume, right? Okay, let's use a real world example. Let's say we want to analyze the historical stock prices for, let's say, the Tesla company. So we will put their daily closing prices for the last 15 days, or let's say just for one day at the moment, and then we will get the last 15 days as well. So is equal to stock history, right? And then we need to put the ticker symbol for the Tesla, TSLA, right? And then let's use the date. Let's say we are going to ask for 3rd of March of 2025, right? And then enter it. Then it will give us the closing prices for as on 3rd of March of 2025. As we have used only one of the date here, start date, it automatically by default it will count it as a close date. Okay, let's say we want to get it for the last 15 days, then we have to give the start date and then the close date as well, is equal to stock history, right? And then stock history, and then the symbol, that is TSLA, right? And then the start date is, let's say, 23rd of March to 2025, and then let's say we are going to get it till 15th of March. It's not 15 days, but yeah, 15th of March of 2025, and then close it, and then it will give us all the closing prices as per these dates, right? But what we need to just keep one thing in mind: interval is not provided and defaulted to daily means zero, right? And then the header is not provided and default, as we haven't provided any header, so by default it will be date and the close. And then we can see the stock history function returns. It has returned us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 results because the weekends are excluded, right? So it doesn't count the weekend. So it only counts the weekdays. So the stock history function, it retrieves like daily. We can also use daily 0 and then weekly 1 and then monthly 2. So if we want to get the monthly, then what we are going to use now, instead of writing it manually, we are also going to use the cell reference. So in cell reference, let's write the ticker name here, and then the start date is, we are going to ask for monthly. So let's say for the last year, from 1st of January 2024 to 31st of December 2024, right? So this is the last year. So now we are going to get the information for stock history, right? For this one, and then from start date is from here, and then the end date is this one. And then if it's monthly, so you can select it from here. 0 account as a daily, 1 as a weekly, and 2 for monthly. So we are going to get it monthly. So let's use 2, and then it will give us all the values. Why the it has give us? Because of the date. Because the date, if I have written it 012. So let's do it, and then it has picked up all the months now, from January, February, March, April, and then the onwards till December 2024, right? So when the interval is provided as 2, so we have provided it as a 2, so it returns the last closing price in the given month. So it has given last closing price for the given month, right? So in this month, the closing price was 403.84 for December 2024, right? So the next one we can, so we have used a cell reference here instead of writing it manually. So change this one to Apple, and then it will automatically change it to Apple, right? So now we are going to use the additional properties, right? So the properties, it can be controlled by customizing and reordering number, starting with the property arguments. So let's say stock history, right? So we are going to ask it for the ticker symbol for the company is Apple, and then the start date, we are going to use the same start date. And then the end date, we are going to use, let's say this one, but we will change this one later. Okay, now we are going to give the additional properties. So we are going to ask for monthly, right? And then the headers, yes, 0, no headers, we don't need any headers. And then we are going to ask it for like a closing price, high, volume, or low, right? So we are going to ask for the closing close, and then for open, and then let's say for high as well, and then for volume as well, right? We have given so many properties arguments here, and then close it, and then it will take some time, and then it will give us the data. So as we haven't given any headers here, so if we want to give the headers, just change 0 to 1. Now it will provide us the headers as well. Enter. See, so this was the column Q, it was the closing price. Column O, R is the open, and then the high was this much, and then the volume for that company was this much, right? So in this way, we can give the as many as properties we want to give, right? So the next one, to analyze these data, right? How we can to analyze these data, we can convert this one into a chart or a line chart, right? So what we need to do, we need to, let's say we are going to analyze this one, select this one and then go to insert tab, and then we are going to give the line chart, right? So it has given us this line chart here as well. So based on these monthly closing prices, so in this way we can also give the chart as well. It depends on you, what type of chart do you want, and then if you want to learn how to insert the charts, then I'll put the another link in the description so you can check it there. Yeah, that's it. The stock history function is a game changer for anyone working with stock data in Excel. It helps us to get the historical price amount for any trading company. So yeah, give it a try and let me know in the comment how you are using it. And at the end, don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and then don't forget to hit the bell icon button for more Excel tips and tricks. Thanks for watching, and then I'll see you again with a new video. Bye for now.